Good morning, students. Now today I am going to explain the fitting of a Poisson distribution. In last class we discussed the mean, variance, mode of a Poisson distribution and related problems. All are completed. Now the last module is fit a Poisson distribution to the following data. What is the data here? X equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Its observed frequencies are 109, 65, 22, 3, 1. These are the observed frequencies. Here total frequency is in this one. So coming to solution, total frequency is 109 plus 65 plus 22 plus 3 plus 1. That is equal to 200. But the Poisson distribution mainly depends on its mean lambda. So we have to calculate lambda. That is mean is equal to sigma xi fi by sigma fi. Sigma xi fi means 0 into 109 plus 1 into 65 plus 2 into 22 plus 3 into 3 plus 4 into 1 by sigma fi. Sigma fi means total frequency, that is equal to already calculated 200. So its mean is 0.61. So lambda is 0.61. This is the value of lambda and this is the value of n. Then coming to the Poisson distribution actual formula, it is e power minus lambda into lambda power x by x factorial. X varies from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 4. So Poisson distribution can be written as p of x equal to x is e power minus 0.61 into 0.61 whole power x by x factorial. This is the Poisson distribution formula and observed frequency is f. Therefore, total frequency is or expected frequency of the Poisson distribution or the binomial distribution is E is equal to N into its corresponding probabilities. N into P of X equal to X. Then calculate Poisson distribution table. So, for this one, first we x values, then its observed frequency OF, next its corresponding probabilities P of X using this formula, next its expected frequency E. First x values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. At 0, observed frequency 109, 65, 22, 3, 1. Its probability is at x equal to 0, x equal to 1, at 2, at 1 is, at 0 is e power minus 0.61 into 0.61 whole power 0 by 0 factorial. By 0 factorial. That is equal to e power minus 0.61. Next at 1, its probability is e power 0.61 into 0.61 whole power 1 by 1 factorial. At 2, e power minus 0.61 into 0.61 whole square by 2 factorial. At 3, e power minus 0.61 into 0.61 whole cube by 3 factorial. At 4, e power minus 0.61 into 0.61 whole power 4 by 4 factorial using this formula. This is the value of P of X equal to X. Here X by 0, we get P of X equal to 0. X by 1, we get P of X equal to 1. X by 2, P of X equal to 2. And here X by 3, P of X equal to 3. Then expected frequency. Expected frequency is N into its corresponding probabilities. So first one is 200 into e power minus 0.61. And next one is 200 into e power minus 0.61 into 0.61. Next one is 200 into corresponding probability e power minus 0.61 into 0.61 whole square by 2 factorial means 2. Next one is 200 into e power minus 0.61 into 0.61 whole cube by 3 factorial means 6. Next 200 into e power minus 0.61 into 0.61 whole power 4 by 4 factorial means 24. And first one is 108.69, approximately 109. Second one is approximately 66. Third one is 20. Next one is approximately 4. Next one is approximately 1. This is the expected frequencies. The total observed expected frequency is also 200. And observed frequency is also 200. That is the fitting of a Poisson distribution. Once again, in this one, first calculate n, either in binomial or in Poisson distribution. First compute the total frequency. Then calculate the mean using the formula sigma xi fi by sigma fi, both in binomial and Poisson. First we calculate the mean using this formula in binomial, then calculate, after calculation of mean, then calculate p also. In binomial, mean is np, here mean is lambda. What is n? This is the value of n, highest value of x in any problem, especially in binomial distribution. So here lambda equal to 0.61, then write the distribution formula. Here Poisson distribution, e power minus lambda into lambda power x by x factorial. But binomial ncx, p power x, q power n minus x. So we need n, p, q. N is, this is the value of n. P means we are equating mean is equal to np, and then replace n by 4. Then we get the value of p, just q 1 minus p. Then apply the binomial distribution. But in Poisson distribution, we need only one parameter, that is lambda, that equals 0.61. So by Poisson distribution, the formula is e power minus lambda into lambda power x by x factorial. Here lambda is 0.61. So substitute lambda by 0.61. Then expected frequency, either in binomial or in Poisson, the expected frequency is total frequency into its corresponding probabilities. So first we calculate the probabilities. For this one, we construct the table. It consists of four columns. One is x, second one is observed frequency, third one is probabilities, and fourth one is expected frequency. X values 0 to 4, observed frequencies 109, 65, 22, 3, 1. Then probability, calculate the probability using this one. X by 0, x by 1, x by 2, x by 3, x by 4. Then total frequency is probability into its total frequency. Then round off the value. Round off the value of the expected frequency. For example, in first one, expected frequency is 108.69, that is approximately equal to 109. Next one is 66.29, that is approximately equal to 66. Next one is 20.22, that is equal to 20. Next one is 4.11, that equal to 4. Next one is 0.63, that is equal to 1. Then total frequency is 200. That is the fitting of a Poisson distribution. Now I am going to explaining the another distribution, normal distribution. Previously we discussed the binomial distribution, Poisson distribution. Now normal distribution. Binomial and Poisson both are discrete distributions. Both are discrete distributions. Whereas normal distribution is a continuous distribution. Random variables are of two types. One is discrete random variable, second one is continuous random variable. So distributions are of two types, discrete distributions, continuous distributions. discrete distributions, the best example is probability mass function for a discrete random variable, probability density function for continuous random variable. Then we discussed the probability distributions for discrete and continuous, that is binomial, Poisson and normal, in which binomial distribution, Poisson distribution, both are related to discrete random variable. So these two are called discrete distributions, and normal distribution is related to continuous random variable. So it is called continuous distribution. Continuous distribution. So now the topic is normal distribution. Normal distribution. It is a continuous distribution. Normal distribution is a continuous distribution, whereas binomial and Poisson are discrete distributions. So binomial and Poisson both are denoted by the symbol P of x equal to x. Both binomial and Poisson. Binomial is ncx, p power x, q power n minus x. And Poisson is e power minus lambda, lambda power x by x factorial. Here the range of x is x equal to 0, 1, 2, so on, n. Here the range of x is 0, 1, 2, so on, infinity. But the binomial distribution involves three parameters, n, p, q. The Poisson distribution involves only one parameter, that is lambda. That is lambda. Both are discrete distributions, so both are denoted by the same symbol P of x equal to x. It's nothing but probability of x number of success is ncx, p power x, q power n minus x. Then x is equal to 0, 1, 2, so on, n. In the case of binomial distribution, in binomial distribution, mean is np, variance is npq, mode is n plus 1 into p. In Poisson distribution, p of x equal to x is e power minus lambda, lambda power x by x factorial, x varies from 0, 1, 2, so on, infinity. Here, the mean is lambda, variance is lambda, mode is also lambda. Now, normal distribution, it is a continuous distribution, so it is denoted by f of x equal to x. Both f and p represents probability. Only for the sake of convenience, for discrete and or for the sake of difference between Poisson, discrete and continuous, normal distribution denoted by f of x equal to x. But the representation is same meaning, probability of x number of success. Here also probability of x number of success. It's defined as 1 by root of 2 pi sigma, root of 2 pi sigma, e power minus 1 by 2 into x minus mu by sigma whole square. A random variable capital X is said to have a normal distribution if its distribution function is given by 1 by root of 2 pi into sigma, e power minus 1 by 2 into x minus mu by sigma whole square. Where mu is the mean of the normal distribution and sigma is the standard deviation of the normal distribution. Mu is mean of the normal distribution, sigma is the standard deviation of the normal distribution. So here mu is mean of the normal distribution, sigma standard deviation, sigma square variance, sigma square is the variance. Mu is mean, sigma is standard deviation, sigma square is the variance. Once again, a discrete random variable capital X is said to have a binomial distribution if its distribution is given by P of X equal X is ncx, p power x, q power n minus x. Next, a discrete random variable is said to have a Poisson distribution if its distribution is given by P of x equal x is e power minus lambda into lambda power x by x factorial. Then the range of x 0 to infinity. A continuous random variable is said to have a normal distribution if its distribution is given by 1 by f of x equal to x is 1 by root of 2 pi, no root for sigma, into sigma, e power minus 1 by 2 into x minus mu by sigma whole square. What is the range of x here? Minus infinity less than x less than infinity. That is the range of x. Try to remember the range of x in the binomial, in Poisson and normal distribution. In the binomial, x equal to 0 to n, n means finite value up to 20. N is more than 20, then apply Poisson distribution and it is also a discrete case. But x values lies in the interval like minus infinity less than x less than infinity, minus 2 plus. We can apply normal distribution. It is a continuous distribution. And its distribution function is given by this one. And see the difference between binomial, Poisson and normal distributions. All three are the probability distributions. Among the three, first two are related to discrete distribution, third one related to continuous distribution. In all the distribution, the main parameters are mean, variance, standard deviation and mode. We already discussed the mean, variance and mode of the normal binomial distribution and Poisson distribution. Here there is no derivations for the mean and variance and standard deviations of the normal distribution. These topics are less important compared to binomial and Poisson distribution. So try to remember the symbol only mu, mean, sigma, standard deviation, sigma square, variance of the normal distribution, and remember the function value f of x equal to x is 1 by root of 2 pi sigma e power minus 1 by 2 into x minus mu by sigma whole square. Here x varies from minus infinity to plus infinity. And what is the graph of a normal distribution? Next one is graph of a normal distribution. Graph of a normal distribution. What is the graph of a normal distribution? Normal distribution is a generally bell-shaped curve. This is the curve of the normal distribution from minus infinity to plus infinity, and it is a bell-shaped curve. It is a bell-shaped curve and peaks maximum value at x equal to mu, that is f of x. What is f of x? 1 by root of 2 pi into sigma e power minus 1 by 2 into x minus mu by sigma whole square. Normal distribution is a bell-shaped curve. It's like bell. From minus infinity to plus infinity, and peaks maximum value at x equal to mu. The reason is at x equal to mu it is e power 0, e power 0 value 1. In any distribution total area is 1. So this value becomes 1 when x equal to mu. So this curve peaks or attains maximum value at x equal to mu. So what is the graph of a normal distribution? It is a bell-shaped curve from minus infinity to plus infinity and attains maximum value at x equal to mu, and this is the value of f of x. And what are the conditions here? The first condition is, each probability is always greater than or equal to 0. It is always positive, but it is 0 when the event cannot happen. And second one is, total area is minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. Total area under the normal distribution is 1. So minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx equal to 1, and each probability is greater than or equal to 0. This is the graph of a normal distribution. Next one, coming to the area under the normal curve. Area under the normal curve. Area under the normal distribution. Area under the normal distribution. Area under the normal distribution or under the binomial or under the Poisson distribution, all are denoted with P of A less than X less than B. So P of A less than X less than B, nothing but P of A less than X less than B, nothing but integral x equal to a to b f of x dx. Why are applying integration under the normal distribution? It is a continuous distribution. Since it is a continuous distribution, but binomial and Poisson are discrete. So p of a less than x less than b nothing but add all values in between a and b. You are adding in binomial and Poisson, but in normal we are integrating. Since it is a discrete distribution, it is a continuous distribution. So p of a less than x less than b is x equal to a to b f of x dx. And it is equal to x equal to a to b. What is f of x? 1 by root of 2 pi into sigma e power minus 1 by 2 into f of x value. X minus mu by sigma whole square into dx. We are not doing the integration directly. Since it involves a complicated term x minus mu by sigma. So put x minus mu by sigma equal to z. X minus mu by sigma is equal to z. Next, when x equal to a, z is a minus mu by sigma. A minus mu by sigma, let it be c. When x equal to b, z is equal to b minus mu by sigma, that equal to d. So a becomes c, b becomes d. And what is the substitution? X minus mu equal to sigma. So what about dx? This is the substitution, x minus mu by sigma equal to z. Then apply the differentiation on both sides. Dx by sigma equal to dz, then dx equal to sigma dz. Therefore, p of a less than x less than b becomes integration c to d. A becomes c, b becomes d, 1 by root of 2 pi into sigma e power minus 1 by 2 into z square. Into dx. What about dx? Sigma dz. Here sigma cancel. So it is equal to integral c to d 1 by root of 2 pi e power minus 1 by 2 into this z square can be written as z minus 0 by 1 whole square into dz. That is equal to integral c to d pi of z dz, where pi of z is 1 by root of 2 pi into 1 e power minus 1 by 2 into z minus 0 by 1 whole square is a standard normal distribution. Standard normal distribution. Why it is called standard normal distribution? It is a distribution with mean is equal to 0. So we are writing z square as z minus 0 whole square by 1. And sigma is 1. Is like in the form of e power minus 1 by 2 into x minus mu by sigma. So mu by 0, sigma by 1. Standard deviation is 1, mu is 0. So it is called a standard normal distribution. Since its mean is equal to 0, sigma is equal to 1. So p of a less than x less than b becomes, a less than x less than b becomes p of c less than z less than d. A less than x less than b means area under the normal curve. C less than z less than d nothing but area under the standard normal curve. We have the area under the standard normal curve in the form of tables. We have plenty of tables under the area under the standard normal distribution. So try to convert the area under the normal curve into area under the standard normal curve. What is the standard normal curve? With p of x, p of z equal 1 by root of 2 pi e power minus 1 by 2 into z minus 0 by 1 whole square. So p of a less than x less than b is p of c less than z less than d. Left side is the area under the normal distribution. Right side is the area under the standard normal distribution. Then divide this one into two parts or more than two parts or one part or more than two part or more than one part. Then calculate the area under the standard normal distribution with the help of statistical tables, not directly. We have a statistical tables. In this, the first table is area under the standard normal distribution. Later we discuss how to convert and how to calculate area under the standard normal distribution. First, once again, here, graph of a normal distribution. It is a bell-shaped curve which extends from minus infinity to plus infinity. And each probability is more than 0 or equal to 0 only in exceptional case. And total area is 1, minus infinity to plus infinity, f of x dx is equal to 1. Well-shaped curve which extends from minus infinity to plus infinity and attains maximum value at x equal to mu. And properties are, each probability is greater than or equal to 0. Area under the normal curve is 1. Area means p of minus infinity less than x less than infinity or minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx equal to 1. So next one, how to calculate the area under the normal curve? Here we take this continuous random variable which varies from x equal to a to b. So p of a less than x less than b is integral x equal to a to b f of x dx. F of x value 1 by root of 2 pi into sigma into e power minus 1 by 2 x minus mu by sigma whole square. We know the value of f of x. This integration cannot be possible directly since it involves a complicated term x minus mu by sigma. So using the substitution we can solve easily. The substitution is z equal to x minus mu by sigma. Then apply differentiation on both sides, dx by sigma equal dz. So sigma dx equal sigma dz. Then apply limits. When x equal to a, z is a minus mu by sigma, let it be c. When x equal to b, z is b minus mu by sigma, let it be d. So a becomes c, b becomes d, dx becomes sigma dz. Apply these three values in p of a less than x less than b, that equals c2d. 1 by root of 2 pi into sigma e power minus 1 by 2. This is z square, dx is sigma dz. Then after simplification it is c2d 1 by root of 2 pi e power minus 1 by 2 into z square can be written as, only for the sake of convenience or for identifying the mean and standard deviations, we can write z square as z minus 0 by 1 whole square. That means mean is 0, sigma is 1. C power minus 1 by 2 into z minus 0 by 1 whole square dz. It is denoted by pi of z. So p of a less than x less than b is c2d pi of z dz, where pi of z is, this is the value of pi of z with mean equal to 0, standard deviation is 1. So it is called standard normal distribution. So area p of a less than x less than b under the normal curve is equal to area under the standard normal distribution, p of c less than z less than d. P of c less than z less than d. This is the area under the normal curve or conversion of normal curve into standard normal curve. Standard normal curve. And what is the graph of a standard normal curve? So area under the normal distribution is p of a less than x less than b is p of a less than x less than b is equal to p of c less than z less than d. Here x is normal variate or normal variable. Normal variate. And z is standard normal variate. Standard normal variate. X is called normal variate, z is called standard normal variate. Then what is the graph of a standard normal distribution? Graph of a standard normal distribution or normal curve. Standard normal curve. Graph of a standard normal curve. It is also a bell-shaped curve. It is also a bell-shaped curve. Extends from minus infinity to plus infinity. But peaks maximum value at z equal to 0. But normal distribution is also a bell-shaped curve from minus infinity to plus infinity and attains maximum value at x equal to mu. But standard normal distribution attains maximum value at z equal to 0. The reason is its pi of z value is, pi of z is 1 by root of 2 pi into e power minus 1 by 2 into z square. When z equal to 0, it becomes e power 0, e power 0 value 1, and total area under the any curve is 1. So here this value becomes 1 when z equal to 0. So according to the standard normal curve, the curve is maximum and z equal to 0. But normal distribution attains maximum value when x equal to mu. But standard normal distribution attains maximum value at z equal to 0. And here, what are the properties of the standard normal distribution? These properties are very, very important in solving of problems or conversion of normal distribution into standard normal distribution. Here, the first property is p of minus infinity less than z less than infinity is equal to 1. Total area in between minus infinity and plus infinity under the standard normal distribution is 1. That is the first one. Second one, p of minus infinity less than z less than 0. Total left side area is equal to p of right side area z 0 less than z less than infinity. Both are equal to 0.5. Since total area is 1, left side area is 0.5, right side area is also 0.5. Total area is 1, left side area is 0.5, right side area is 0.5. So left side area is equal to right side area. That means P of minus A less than Z less than 0 is equal to P of 0 less than Z less than A. Minus A to 0 represents area under the curve lies on left side. 0 less than z less than A lies on right side. So minus A to 0 nothing but 0 to A. So convert negative area into positive area or left side area into positive area. Since our statistical tables only for the right side area. Our statistical tables are only for right side area. So minus A to 0 converted into 0 to A. Both are same. For example, this is the value of minus A and this is the value of plus A according to this curve. Minus A and plus A both are at equidistance from the origin. From the origin. From 0 to A units on left side means minus A, on right side means plus A. The equidistance from the origin, 0. So minus A to 0 nothing but 0 to A. And next one is fourth property, P of minus A less than Z less than A. Minus A to plus A is nothing but 2 into P of 0 less than Z less than A. Minus A to plus A. For example, this is minus A and it is plus A. Minus A to plus A means minus A to 0 plus 0 to A. And this is the value of minus A. For example, this is the value of plus A. So what is the area in between minus A and plus A means minus A to 0 plus 0 to A. minus a2 is 0, nothing but again 0 dA. So left side is 0 dA, right side is 0 dA, total area is 2 into 0 dA. So minus a to a is nothing but 2 into p of 0 less than z less than a. And next one is fifth property. Fifth one is equal to p of z1 less than z less than z2. P of z1 less than z less than z2 is equal to area at z1, area at z2 plus area at z1. Area at Z2 plus area at Z1. Area at Z1 and area at Z2 both are obtained from the statistical tables. So P of Z1 less than Z2 nothing but area of Z2 plus area of Z1. Second ordinate plus first ordinate. Area of Z1 and area of Z2 both are obtained from the statistical tables. Statistical direct values, no calculations. The calculations are not required. Both are obtained from the statistical tables. Statistical tables. And next one is second one, sixth one. If z less 1, if z1 greater than 0, positive, then p of z greater than z1 is p of z greater than z1. Z1 greater than 0. Greater than 0 means lies on right side. Lies on right side. Z1 value. Then P of Z greater than Z1 is Z greater than Z1 nothing but 0.5 minus area at Z1. 0.5 minus area at Z1. Total right side area is 0.5 minus area at Z1. Next one, seventh one is, if Z1 less than 0, Z less than 0 means lies on left side, then P of Z less than, Z greater than Z1 is 0.5, negative side, lies on negative side, then it is total 0.5 plus this value, 0.5 plus A of Z1. 0.5 plus A of Z1. And next eighth one is, if Z1 positive, Z1 greater than 0, then Z1 greater than 0, then P of Z less than Z1. Positive side, Z1 greater than means 0 means lies on positive side, lies on right side, then P of Z less than Z1 means 0.5 Z1 is, one is Z1 is greater than 0, so 0.5 plus A of Z1. Lies on positive side, Z1 greater than 0, lies on positive side. So P of Z less than Z1, up to Z1 means 0.5 plus this value, left side area plus this value. And next, ninth one, if Z1 less than 0, then P of Z less than Z1 is, Z less than Z1 is 0.5 minus A of Z1. Z1. These are the properties of the standard normal distribution. All are important. First one is total area from minus infinity to plus infinity is equal to 1. Second one, left side area minus infinity less than Z less than 0 is equal to right side area 0 less than Z less than infinity. Both are equal to 0.5. Minus a less than z less than 0 area is equal to p of 0 less than z less than a. Left side area is equal to right side area according to any ordinate. Next, minus a to a. Minus a less than z less than a is equal to 2 into p of 0 less than z less than a. Next, probability between any two z1 less than z less than z2 is a of z2 plus A of Z1. AFZ1 and AFZ2 both are obtained from the statistical tables. Here calculations are not required. Both are obtained directly from statistical tables. If Z1 is positive, positive means lies on right side. Less than 0 means lies on negative side. So if Z1 is positive, then P of Z greater than Z1 is 0.5 minus area at Z1. If Z1 is negative, then P of Z greater than Z1 is 0.5 plus, remember, positive means subtraction, negative means addition. Here, in less than symbol, positive means addition, greater than symbol means addition, less than symbol means subtraction, opposite, both, for both are greater than and less than. If Z1 greater than 0, so P of Z greater than Z1 is 0.5 minus area at Z1. Z1 positive, so you are applying negative. If Z1 less than 0, so it is 0.5 plus area at Z1, whenever P of Z greater than Z1. If Z1 greater than 0, then probability of Z less than Z1 is direct one. Positive means addition, negative means subtraction. So 0.5 plus a of z1, 0.5 minus a of z1 when z1 less than 0. In the case of p of z less than z1. Here p of z less than z1, here p of z greater than z1. Both are opposite to each other. These are the properties of the standard normal distribution. So area under the normal distribution is p of a less than x less than b is p of c less than z less than d. Here x is a normal variate, z is a standard normal variate. So what is the graph of a standard normal curve? It is a bell-shaped curve from minus infinity to plus infinity and attains maximum value at z equal to 0. What are the properties? Total area is 1, left side area is equal to right side area, both are equal to 0.5. Next, minus a less than z less than 0 is p of 0 less than z less than a, and p of minus a less than z less than a is 2 into p of 0 less than z less than a, and probability between any two ordinates is addition of the two ordinates a of z2 plus a of z1. If z1 greater than 0, then p of z greater than z1 is 0.5 minus area of z1. If z1 is negative, then P of Z greater than Z1 is 0.5 plus A of Z1. Then opposite in the case of P of Z less than Z1. If Z1 greater than 0, then P of Z less than Z1 is 0.5 plus A of Z1. Z1 less than 0, then P of Z less than Z1 is 0.5 minus area at Z1. Area at Z1. These are the properties of standard normal distribution. Then coming to the problems on normal distribution. Now coming to the problems on normal distribution. Here the very first problem is, if x is a normal variate with mean equal to 30 and the standard deviation is 5. So what are the given conditions? Given that mean equal to 30. Mean mu is equal to 30. Standard deviation shortcuts SD, sigma is equal to 5. Then find the probabilities that 26 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 40, x greater than or equal to 45, x less than or equal to 25. In between 26 and 40, more than or equal to 45, up to 25, according to normal distribution. So x is a normal variate. So according to normal distributions, in this one we need two parameters, that is mean mu, standard deviation sigma. In all the normal distribution problem, the substitution is z equal to x minus mu by sigma, that equal to x minus 30 by 5. By fixing the mean is 30, sigma is 5. Then coming to the first problem, P of 26 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 40. That is the very first problem. In this one, first when x equal to 26, when x equal to 26, what is z? Z equal to 26 minus 30 by 5, minus 4 by 5, that equal to minus 0.8, minus 0.8. Next, when x equal to 40, upper limit, then z equal to 40 minus 30 by 5, 10 by 5, 2. Next, therefore, P of 26 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 40 becomes P of minus 0.8 less than or equal to z less than or equal to 2. 26 becomes minus 0.8, 40 becomes 2, so it is minus 0.8 less than z less than 2. It is in the form of P of z1 less than or equal to z less than or equal to z2. Z1 is minus 0.8, 2 is Z2. So, by the properties, P of Z1 less than Z less than Z2 is A at 2 plus A at minus 0.8. A of Z2 plus A of Z1. A of Z2 is A of 2. A of Z1 means minus 0.8. Or for the sake of convenience, let it be Z1 and let it be Z2. So, area at Z2 plus area at Z1 by the properties. Again, by the properties, area of 2 plus area of minus 0.8 is again A of 0.8. A of minus 0.8 means left side area at 0.8 is equal to right side area at 0.8. Both are same. Since total left side area is exactly equal to right side area under the normal distribution. Since it is attains maximum value and Z equal to 0. What is the value of A of 2? A of 2 is 0.4772 from the table. And the A of 0.8 is 0.2881. We already supplied the values. These values are obtained from the statistical tables. Directly see the table. For example, table is like this. Here, 0.1 like that. And next 2. Then here 0, 1, 2, 3 like that. Suppose we want to calculate 2.01. So calculate 2 and then 1. 2.1. 2, 2 means 2, then here corresponding to 2.2 means 2 and corresponding value 2. Like that. 2.3, 2 then 3. So, here this value is A of 2 value 0.4772, A of 0.8 is 0.2881, that equal to 0.7653. And next one is, second one is P of x greater than or equal to 45. X greater than or equal to 45. P of x greater than or equal to 45. So, in this one, first calculate z. When x equal to 45, z is 45 minus 30 by sigma 5, 15 by 5, 3. Let it be z1. This z1 is positive. This z1 is positive. Clearly, z1 greater than 0. Is 3 positive greater than 0. So P of x greater than or equal to 45 becomes P of z greater than or equal to 3. By the properties z greater than z1 and z1 is positive, then it is 0.5 minus area at z1. Area at z1. So that is equal to 0.5 minus area at Z1 means 3. So 0.5 minus area at 3 is, area at 3 from the table 0.4985. So its value is 0.00135. Its direct value. A of 3 obtained from statistical table. Directly in the first column we see the 3. Then top 0. First column 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. Then choose the value of 3 in first column. Then our right side like 0, 0, 1, 2, 3 are there. These are the decimal points. 3.1 means 3, then see the value 1. 3 means directly 3 and 0. Then round up the value from the table statistical table, that is 0.4985, 0.00135. See here Z1 is positive, so greater than 0. So P of X greater than or equal to 45 means P of Z greater than or equal to 3. And this 3 is a positive. Positive means subtraction, especially in normal distribution, 0.5 minus area at Z1. Area at Z1. Here Z1 is 3, area at 3. 0.5 minus area at 3 is 0.4985 from the statistical tables. That is equal to 0.00135. Next, third one is P of X less than or equal to 25. Less than or equal to 25. Here, when x equal to 25, when x equal to 25, z is 25 minus 30 by 5. That equal to minus 1. Let it be z1. Here clearly z1 is negative. Z1 is negative. Therefore, P of X less than or equal to 45 is, sorry, 25, less than or equal to 25 is P of Z less than or equal to minus 1. And Z1 is minus 1, it is a negative, up to value. So it is 0.5 negative, so 0.5 minus area at Z1. 0.5 minus area at minus 1, that is called 0.5 minus area at minus 1, nothing but area at 1. So 0.5 area at 1 is 0.3413. So value is 0.14871. This is the area at X less than or equal to 25. Once again, given that mean is equal to 30, sigma is equal to 5, and here the substitution is z equal to x minus mu by sigma. So, if z is equal to x minus 30 by 5, by fixing the mean and standard deviations. Next, coming to the first problem, P of 26 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 45. So, calculate the values of z when x equal to 26, when x equal to 40. Let it be Z1 and Z2 respectively. So Z1 is minus 0.8, Z2 is 2. So P of 26 less than or equal to X less than or equal to 40 becomes minus 0.8 less than or equal to Z less than or equal to 2. X becomes Z, 26 becomes minus 0.8, 40 becomes 2. It is a normal distribution, it is a standard normal distribution. It is like in the form of P of Z1 less than or equal to Z less than or equal to Z2. By the properties, it is A of Z2 plus A of Z1, A of 2 plus A of minus 0.8. Again, A of minus 0.8 is A of 0.8. Again, from the properties, A of 2 is 0.4772 from the table. A of 0.8 is 0.2881. So value is 0.7653. Next, x greater than or equal to 45. When x greater than 45, calculate the value of z, that is 3. It is a positive. 3 positive value. So x greater than or equal to 45 becomes z greater than or equal to 3, and 3 is a positive means 0.5 minus area at 3. are area at Z1. Area at 3 is 0.4985, its value is 0.00135. Suppose this Z1 value negative and this greater than symbol is there, for example, x greater than or equal to 55 and Z1 is negative, then 0.5 plus area at Z1, area at Z1. Whenever x greater than or equal to 45 and Z1 is negative, then its value is 0.5 plus area of Z1. Here positive, Z1 is positive, so it is 0.5 minus area at Z1. Area of 3 value 0.4985, that 0.00135. When x less than or equal to 25, when x is 25, Z is 25 minus 30 by 5, that equal to minus 1, is a negative value. Z1 is negative and x less than or equal to 25 becomes Z less than or equal to minus 1, it is a negative value, so 0.5 minus area at Z1. Area of minus 1, area of minus 1 is again area of 1, area of 1 is 0.3413, that equals 0.14871. Suppose Z1 is positive,